What's going on, mi familia? The hashtag PVT Professional Valley Talk. Papa Sustame, one time rock and roll James, dándole las gracias a todos ustedes. All you subscribers, thank you so much. And if you haven't subscribed, well, what are you waiting for? Hit the subscribe button right now and subscribe. Y pégale la campanita, a little bell, para cuando I upload algo, pues de volá, you get notified. Ya sabes, es todo. Want to thank our latest pledges for my Patreon page. The link is down there if you want to be part of this show. And till the end of March, this is what we're doing. You get a free hashtag PVT t-shirt that nobody else is going to have. I got some messages through my Facebook fan page, the Rock and Roll James. Hey, is there any way to get those t-shirts besides YouTube and Patreon? No, no, no. Only the Patreon people are going to get it. So congratulations to Ray Torres, Jesse Pacheco, and Jerry Garcia Jr. They pledged $25 to the hashtag PVT show, and I am going to be sending them a t-shirt, a hashtag PVT t-shirt. I'll be getting them this Thursday, and we're going to start mailing them out this weekend. So if you haven't pledged, do it right now. Let's do it, because this show is going to be traveling all over the place, and it's going to be because of you supporting the show. Thank you so much. Asustame one time.
How do bands make a living? They make a living on their live shows. They got to make a living. Also, you got to spend money to make money, of course. You got to spend money to promote your band. And to go in the studio, you know it costs money to go in the studio. How many hours are you going to be there? You know, studio time.
Pero la gente ya no quiere comprar música, bro. Ya no quieren comprar música, bro. Man. Especially the younger generation who didn't. I mean, unos, los viejones, you know, todavía, you know, hey, ¿sabes qué? Vamos a comprar un CD, vamos a comprar. Aunque no lo oigamos, pero ahí lo vamos a tener porque, hey, we like to buy the music, we like to have the product, we like to have the pictures, the fold out and all that.
Right.
But the new generation, they don't know nothing about that, bro.
No.
They've never bought a CD. They've
I don't think they've ever read credits on it.
No. So, you know, it's going to get to the point where there won't be any money in music. And the fortunate thing is que we can perform and make money by performing with the music.
Come
but
out.
There's a lot of songwriters that just write songs, you know, Beto Ramon, you know, Luis Silva, guys like that that didn't perform. They wrote songs and they made a lot of money through royalties.
Right.
That dried up for those people because, you know, nobody's buying CDs anymore or they're, you know. But
when you make a CD, it's so hard because you got so many songwriters, so many people that get some pieces of pie. What does the music get left?
The look gig money.
That's it. That's what they say. That's the what they say. Money. But also the gig money, they have to show up. The fans got to go to the shows, you know?
And we're still getting it free también.
Exactly. I'm about to say that. Oye, man, carnal. Hey, look, I bought you a bunch of cassettes, man. You can't get me in, carnal. Come on, you know? I'm like, I say, where do you work at sometimes? Well, I work at the auto parts. Can I have some free parts? Oh, no, man.
Can you play for free? Yeah, we can play for free, but we got to charge you for the setup.
There you go.
Hey,
that's a good one.
Te cojo cobrar para el setup, pero tocamos free. But, it's like people, you know, a lot of people are getting used to festivals, you know, where the city throws a festival, you know, hires the bands, and it's free for the for the people. And there's been some festivals where they decide to charge them, you know, $5 to park and then $10 to get near the stage.
Yep.
Y la gente
VIP
no compran el VIP. Se quedan todos afuera y estás tocando enfrente con el VIP es seco.
Exactly.
Y está toda la gente ya bien lejos.
Grite behind the fence.
Y no recibes la energía de la gente. So te agüitas con la tocada, carnal. Tiene la onda. So it's just, there's so many things going on right now with the music industry.
But you know, it's not because they don't want to pay. I don't believe that because, I mean, look how many basketball games are out there, football games are out there, and I see a lot of Tejano fans out there, and I know those tickets are expensive, and the park are expensive. Gee. Season passes are expensive, football, you know, and stuff, and they're out there paying $9 for a cup of beer or something like that, and then you show up at our show, $10? $10 at the door. Like, come on, is it a couple?
No, pero they don't think like $10 at the door, they think, a ver, $10 at the door, el pisto está siete bolas.
Right.
They me voy a pistear unos 20 pistos.
Honey, can you wait in the car?
Le voy a quebrar part-tab. Vamos a lavar vasijas ahora, ¿no? But anyway, so, man, but the good thing is that you're still busy, you're still working, and you're still a wanted, you know, a commodity in the music industry because, of course, not only do you perform great songs that you've, you know, had a stellar career with, but you also put on a great show.
Thank you.
guys, you know, you get up on stage, you se avientan todo ahí. You have the moves and all that stuff, man.
Well,
so
you know,
it's entertaining.
There you go. And that's what we're trying to do, bring back, you know, to the fans and stuff. And the good thing that, you know, the energy is there, you know. Of course, you know, they say, do you work out? Do you exercise? It's like, oh, yeah, but, you know, we ain't got no roadies. We unload ourselves. Mm-hmm. So that's a workout, you know, driving ourselves. And to make it to the shows, it's important for all of us. We still get excited about getting there early, checking the sound out, making sure everything's good. Because a lot of times it does. It does take a lot of time. And, you know, fans might not realize, but when you get to a place, man, we get there kind of early. We try to check the sound out, what's going on and stuff. And you know, rest while we can. So we go on stage, man, it's like another world, right? When you get on stage, it's like
it's a drug.
Exactly.
Yeah, you get a high. I mean, especially when the audience is right there. Oh, you know, God. But when the audience is 20 yards away.
It's different. That's a different kind of feel.
Yeah, it's a different feel, man, because you feel like you're playing to an empty place. But you've also got something going on with a raffle or something.
Well,